What is up, everybody? This is Trent with SallysPitReport.com. We are hanging out here today with Icarus, all the way from Iceland, correct?
Yes.
Okay. So introduce yourselves real quick and what y'all do in the band.
Should we go from
this way?
Yeah, just start down there, yeah.
Hey, what's up? I'm Fannar. I play bass.
I'm Gunnar. I play the shred machine.
Shred machine, okay.
By shred machine, he means guitar. My name is Finnboye, and I sing.
My name is Leivur, and I play the drums.
Okay, awesome. So, you know, I've been calling you Finn and everything. What are some, I guess, your shortened names and all that? Like, if you go and introduce yourselves to somebody, I guess, at McDonald's or wherever you guys might go, or Walmart.
Same order?
Let's go with the Motive's nicknames.
What are their nicknames?
Oh, wow. Yeah.
They've found a couple of nicknames for us. So it's Leaf Boy.
Leaf Boy.
Finn Boy.
Gun Boy.
And Fanboy.
Fanboy?
Obviously.
Nice.
Spin and Fan.
Okay.
Yeah, it's really confusing with our two names because it's literally just one letter that makes it different.
Oh, wow. So the last time you guys played here, you know, I talked to you about this, but just so everybody can hear, you said something about possibly changing a name or getting a different name at some point. What's going on with that? And what does Icarus mean to start off with? And when and what are you? Is a new name, I guess, going to be if y'all have arrived at that?
I'll let him take care of that one.
Okay.
Oh, me? Did you point at me? Sorry, yeah. I'm not. So, start with what Icarus means. It's just a reference to the movie Sunshine, the spaceship Icarus.
Okay.
We also like the lore behind it. Icarus flew too close to the sun with his wax wings, like Greek mythology, all that stuff. You can read up on it if you want.
Okay.
With a new name, we're kind of just, every time we find something we all like, you know, someone already has it. So we're still searching. And, like,
okay,
everything's taken these days. It's hard to find something where
you
won't get, like, a cease and desist if you just start using it, you know.
Yeah. Okay.
So.
And another thing you mentioned, too, is that y'all were possibly label shopping or looking at some labels. Has anything come to fruition since then? And if so, with who?
We're talking with some, but nothing we can really mention by name, you know.
Okay. So still up in the air with that, then?
Yeah.
All right, so you guys are from Iceland. That's interesting. I don't think I've ever met anybody from Iceland before. What's it?
Me neither.
What's it? What's the cultural here like in America versus, I guess, where you guys are from and all that stuff? Was there a lot of culture shock coming over here with the food? Or, you know, I read in an issue of AP, like, some international bands came over here and they saw guns in Walmart and it shocked them because they didn't sell guns in Australia or Britain or anything like that. So.
Oh, absolutely. It is a culture shock, but the two of us lived in America when we were quite young.
Okay.
And learned English through that. I've been to American schools and stuff like that. And, I mean, these guys are city boys. They're kind of used to it. But
okay,
I'd say the cities are fucking massive in comparison to Iceland. Like, and it's hard. Like, it's hard to make real relationships with people there.
Yeah.
But as soon as you come out into the rest of the country where everyone isn't a fuckhead, it's a... It's a great country. Like, yeah.
Okay.
Closer to home.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's like more of small towns or something like that.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Like coming from a country of 300,000 people.
Yeah.
It's a really big difference.
Not saying all city people are assholes. It's just there is a lot of assholes.
Oh, yeah.
Which is hard to deal with for me, at least.
Yeah.
It's really stressful out there. So, like, it totally makes sense. Like, that you if you're like a New Yorker, like, hardcore, like, true to the core, you've always been in New York. You're gonna grow some tough skin.
Yeah.
Because that city's huge.
Oh, yeah, that is true.
Yeah. Okay, so let's talk about your sound a little bit. You guys have I've described it as, you know, different blends and stuff like that. You guys might take it as a compliment, may not, depending on your thoughts on the bands, but I've kind of described it as a Nasty City's Burn meets a Norma Jean or Chariot type fields. It's very, like, got those very melodic sound to it, but yeah, it's very chaotic and sporadic at times. So, like, who are some of your influences, and where does your sound come from?
I think we'll do like a He'll Say His.
Okay, that works.
How about that? Yeah, there you go.
So, I don't know, because like I started playing in the band, September last year?
Okay.
So, like, getting the view of like seeing the band before joining it kind of was really hard for me to kind of establish what kind of sound or what kind of influences they started as.
Yeah.
But I can definitely see some converge stuff like that.
Yeah.
It has that melodic feel, but it's still kind of chaotic.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
But my influence in general.
Oh, yeah. Your influences that you bring to the band, and or where do you get your, I guess, what you bring to the table to get the band sound, I guess.
Yeah, definitely. Me and
that guy over there,
Leivur, we used to be huge metalcore kids when we were younger.
Okay.
And I don't know, like, we like to, well, like, personally for me, because Gunnar is the shred machine over here.
Okay.
So if he brings, like, riffs up to the table and we kind of start working on that, I really like what he's doing. So, mm-hmm. like, I like to structure everything up by, like, I don't know, not preference, but, I mean, like, it's easy. I like what he's doing with that, but
okay,
I'm not really sure what kind of band influences I get from.
Okay.
But, like, it's what it is. I really like it.
Well, I think we all have very different tastes. It's just kind of, because it's all so different, it just turns into something weird. And I kind of like that. Like, we never, you know, from the get-go, we never had, like, a specific sound we were going for. We just kind of wanted to play and see what happened.
Okay.
And, I mean, I think we all like it, even though we come from completely different backgrounds in music and stuff like that.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. What about you?
So this band started out as, like, a post-rock project. With no vocals, and early on I came into the mix, and I come from a lot of different backgrounds. Like, I was I played guitar in like a chaotic mathcore band called In the Company of Men. They're still active and they're doing great stuff, but I kind of separated myself from them to do this band. And so there, you know, we were listening to a lot of proggy stuff, a lot of, like, you know, dissonant, grindy things, and like Daughters, Mr. Bungle, Dillinger Escape Plan, Converge, like that type of stuff. And I still hold that, like, all very dear to my heart.
Okay.
You know, that might not be exactly what we're playing, but
yeah,
because then, you know, his influences are completely different.
Oh,
so
yeah, for sure.
I think that's what makes our sound special.
Yeah. What about you?
So I just joined the band about 2 months ago. Something like that. So I've known the band for 3 years, so I kind of know how their sound, you know, is.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry. But yeah, in that time I kind of, like, gotten to know how their sound is, so I pretty much know how to, like, get my drums to fit with Gunnar's guitar parts.
Okay.
So, like, back home I play in a melodic hardcore band, which is still active also. So that's more kind of a counterparts, No Bragging Rights-ish band. But, I mean, I don't know. I try to bring what I can to this band.
Okay, so I totally get what you... I'm just kidding. Yeah, we're in a new location. It started raining on us. It's been thunder and lightning, so change of scenery here. But yeah, I totally get what you were saying about the whole influences and all that, about everybody bringing something different to make it sound and everything. And talk about the record that you have out right now, what it's called and what it's about and all that cool stuff for the people to check out.
All right. Well, we have a record out now called Ascending Descending. We recorded this record over a year ago in his bedroom, actually.
And then Sick it was
mixed,
studio.
It was mixed by a friend of ours named Hikur Hannes, who lives in Sweden. And he's
Sick
a great
mix man.
Great mix guy. Love him to death. Wonderful person. But so that record, I'll say now, like, it's been a year now since it's been out, and all the songs, they've gotten kind of, they've some of them have gotten a bit old, but we still love them. We still care, like, dearly about that record, because that was a big step for us as a band. The lyrical content on there, like, personally for me, it was a lot about, you know, where I was in an emotional state, living in Iceland and whatnot. And there's some stuff that, like, hints, like, a small taste of what our next records will hopefully be about.
Okay. We can talk about that in terms of, like, releasing or, like, what stage is that record in right now, the new one?
The new record has been demoed completely, I think. We're about to go record.
We'll probably write,
two
more songs or something
like
that.
Yeah, we got, like, two more, maybe. Yeah. But we've demoed 9 songs currently.
Okay.
And we have prepared now. So we've booked a recording schedule with a buddy of ours named Levi. And he lives in West Virginia. And we're going to record at his house.
Plays for Threads. Sick band. Check him out.
Yeah. Check out Threads. Check out Stick Up Kid. Those are both his bands. So we're heading right after this tour. About 10 days later, we're going to go record with him 3 songs for a split with a band that we can't really talk about yet. But
okay.
So we're going to be putting out new material before the end of the year.
Awesome. Well, if anybody watching has seen you guys live, you guys freaking tear it up on stage. It's,
thank you, man.
I think you guys one of the, I guess, one of the most, I guess, emotional and intense bands I've seen. And so,
thank you.
Where does that, you mentioned Converge earlier as a band that you like and stuff like that. Do those bands like that or kind of influence your stage presence any, or do you just the lyrics or the I guess the emotion behind the music like just comes out like when you guys play and all that? Where's your emotional like stage presence and come from and all that sort of stuff?
Well, at least for me, you know, coming from a place like Iceland, you know, it's like this small isolated island in Europe basically, mm-hmm. and coming from there, it's, you know, you kind of overplay your area if you do more than one or two shows every other month or so. So for us at least, I think our performance, it comes from, you know, sitting in an emotional state for too long. It's frustration, it's passion, it's everything we want to make music.
Okay.
Like it's everything that makes us create music. Every time I go on stage, I think this could be my last show, so I'm gonna do my absolute best.
Okay.
And I don't ever wanna think that, like, I don't want to think about a show and be like, eh, this one doesn't matter as much.
Oh, yeah.
Because that's unfair to anyone who's coming to watch. Like, we just played at a vape shop in Virginia. In front of, like,
that's awesome.
In front of, like, 10 people. And we still just played our best because that's what we're trying to do.
Yeah, the PA blew out in the first song.
Oh, wow.
We just kept going.
Okay.
It was fun, though.
It's, you know, we're doing our best because we want to be good.
So you talked about demoing out and writing some more songs, you know, coming up touring-wise and all that. What do you guys have coming up, I guess, the fall throughout the end of the year? Cause since you're going to be writing and all that, you take some time off for that. But, like, what are some, I guess, touring things you guys have for the rest of the year and all that coming up?
Well, I'm not going to say what it is because I don't know if we're allowed to say.
No, just like this.
Yeah.
We have at least one more tour planned for this year, and that's going to be... Yeah, that's going to be our longest tour so far.
Okay.
And we're always trying to book more. Like, we're always trying to grind because we hate sitting around and not doing this band because this is literally all we want to do currently. Like, we have other passions, but this one's the most fun, I think.
Yeah. Sweet. So I got a couple of fun ones for you guys real quick.
Fuck yeah, I love fun. Fun is really
fun. You guys have lived in America, spent time in America for a long time now. So, what do you guys think about Taylor Swift? Is she a girl? Is she your girl, or is she not your girl, or what?
Taylor Swift.
Yeah.
I don't really have an opinion on it, but she's tight. I know Finn is a huge fan of T Swift.
Taylor Swift to me is is a very important icon in pop culture. I support that she took all her music down from Spotify. A lot of people say that it's because she just wanted more money, but I think that she's standing up for the other artists because Spotify's business plan is fucked up. Listen to her record on there, by the way. I think Taylor Swift's pretty tight.
All right, so this moves into this question right here. If you got to date, marry, hang out with her, be best friends, whatever title you want to put on it with Taylor Swift, and she wrote a song about you, What would it be called and what would it be about?
That's a really good one.
That's a really good one.
You're making me think now. I like that. That's good journalism. Figure the song must be, it's probably about a really, like, poorly clad, dirty individual as a just, like, physical dirt. Because we'd probably only hang out when I was not on tour. And whenever I come home from tour, I have no clean clothes at all.
Oh, wow.
So... we're kind of a smelly band, I'm not going to lie.
Who smells the worst?
Definitely.
Blame it on the merch guy.
Shout out to Chris.
He will not shower for Wherever 4 days.
So. Even off tour?
Yes.
Oh,
mainly.
Okay.
Definitely.
Like, mainly off tour.
We're genuinely concerned.
This has happened now when he's like working a week straight, maybe, because we live with him.
Okay.
And so he'll like be working like a straight week, and then he'll... you know, he'll just go straight to bed after he's done, and then he'll wake up, he'll go right to work. So, you know, by the fifth day, it's kind of like, Chris.
Yeah, it's an issue.
Please.
Okay. Wow.
But, yeah, Taylor Swift.
He's a dirty boy, maybe?
Yeah, he's a dirty boy. I think that'd be the name. Dirty Viking boy.
I'm all dirty boy. All
right. And there might be a little, I guess, a band discussion later between you guys and Motives, because I asked them this question. Yeah. If your band was a tribe on the show Survivor and Motives was a tribe on Survivor, who would win? And they said you guys probably wouldn't last that long.
So, really?
Yeah, they'd say they'd take That's you guys down.
Can I have that mic?
Oh, yeah.
What?
Motives, we will fuck you up. I will Fight. Go out of my way to hunt Fight. Down Kevin in any forest possible. Dan has nothing on me.
So, does that show work in different climates, or is it always just some, like, beach island or something?
Yeah, they said y'all basically couldn't take the heat and all that.
I think they're right.
Okay.
I would die of dehydration. But honestly, if it was...
So if this band was on the show as its own tribe, you would be the winner.
I've slept in a Walmart parking lot in July in a van. I can take anything.
Oh, yeah, I kind of had your backs on there. I told them y'all probably resilient and really nice and, you know, really well-kept gentlemen, but you guys probably have, like, this cunning, like, side that they don't see that could probably rip someone's face off if you had to.
I mean, I'm just thinking, you know, if the food runs out, we can kill them and eat them. That's something we could do. I don't know if they would do that. Yeah, we could eat Ian.
Okay. So overall, you guys think
he's straight edge, so he's probably cleaner, you know?
So you guys think straight edge, he's cleaner. That was a good
Something
one.
Like that.
So, long story short, if you guys were a tribe and Motives was a tribe, you think y'all would take them down? At least you would. You think that.
Yeah. I can't say we'd survive, but they would die first.
Yes.
But I don't know if, like, I've never watched the show, so, like,
no one, no, like
it's
I
not
told
like it, people actually die.
Yeah, like I told him earlier,
I think I'm taking this question a bit too seriously.
y'all are both talking about killing. Yeah, exactly. Are y'all, like, y'all must be, like, secret murderers.
I think about this a lot, like, what I would do in dreadful situations where I'm stuck on an island and I have to eat people, you know? It seems like fun to think about.
Okay. And one last question, touring around and everything, what's like a weird, unique, or random item you guys had to sign, a fan has asked you guys to sign or anything?
Your pants.
The what? Oh.
Last time we played here, I ripped my pants pretty bad. Like, this whole leg just completely, like
looked
no
like he was
pants.
Wearing underwear.
I was half naked.
Yeah.
Oh, I remember that.
Yes.
I remember that.
So, I had to sign those pants for someone. That was pretty cool. My buddy Nick got them. It's more about, like, people giving us weird things. Like, one time we were in Georgia and mm-hmm. our tour, like, we played our final show of the tour, and this dude came up to us. He didn't even see us play, but he was really nice, and he bought, like, a vinyl from us and stuff, and he just gave us, like, a karambit, which is a knife.
Yeah.
Mm.
He gave us Pretty a knife. Cool. It's like a hunting knife.
Okay.
Yeah. You want to go into further detail?
Yeah, he was just like, what are you guys packing? We're like, what? He's like, what weapons you got in there? Fucking nothing, you know.
This
so
is
like, I'll be right back.
This is redneck country, so
bands,
I mean,
like, bands will carry weapons sometimes too, because, you know, if they don't get their guarantee and whatnot.
Oh yeah,
we have not done that.
Yeah.
Okay.
But we had a karambit for, like, the end of one tour.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Awesome.
Crazy thing is, there was someone's name carved into it.
Oh.
I don't think it was his, and there's some, like, blood stains. Hopefully it was. I mean, I say hopefully. It's actually equally terrible. It's just. Might be an animal. I don't know.
It was a very
maybe
strong,
a human.
Tall man.
Yeah.
Mm.
He's a Coast Guard, former Coast Guard,
yeah.
I think.
That's interesting.
Yeah. Cool All dude. Right. I loved him, though.
All really right. Good. Then.
Yeah.
Well,
he would do well in Survivor.
Okay.
Yeah.
We also signed our floor tom that we destroyed once.
Yeah. That
okay.
Was that same show, yeah. actually.
Here?
No, that was at a deli in Georgia. It's called Cloud Springs Deli, and
awesome
we
menu.
Destroyed the floor tom because they have a wrestling ring and they wouldn't let us in it. So we had to take our frustrations out somehow differently. So we destroyed the floor tom, and then we gave it to someone. Like, the whole thing must have been a total bitch to carry, but we signed it, and you can find it on Instagram somewhere.
Okay.
So, yeah.
That's awesome. Well, is there anything else you guys want to plug real quick before we wrap it up?
What's this band called that's starting right now?
Death Eater, local band.
Come check out Death Eater right now. upload
here.
This immediately. Right now.
Let me plug one thing. Come to our shows. Listen to our music.
Good plug.
If you see us on the street, don't say hi. We are not nice people.
It's a lie.
Okay. You can't come say hi.
Y'all might smell, though.
I'm a bit too on edge right now. because I haven't slept at all. I'm usually very friendly. Listen to Conflictions. Listen to Distill the World. And don't listen to Fear Factory.
And to top this off, Tread Lightly.
Oh, God. Okay, yeah, those. Those.
Krakapika.
What'd you say?
Oh, God.
What does that mean?
Yeah, weird. Fuck, man.
Okay. All right. On that note, I'm Trent with Sally's Pit Report.
Our Icelandic fans.
This is Icarus. And yeah, the sounds you hear in there is local Death Eater. Go check them out, too. They're awesome. So check it. Thanks for watching, guys.